The general strategies for ensuring that identity data is protected, I could perhaps summarize it into two building blocks. One is on the side of using technology in order to secure the content, and the other one is to use processes in order to secure the content. So I'll try to unpack both of these and give some examples of the two. So obviously the one starting point and go-to tool for most things that pertain to biometric data, because it is data, one can protect it via encryption. So when we encrypt the data, it makes it a little bit hard for those who are not familiar with the field to go and compromise or access that data because it's encrypted. The second thing is one has to think very carefully about where that data is stored and ensure that that storage is secure. Perhaps the third part of the security technology that can be deployed is what might be called security at transport time, when a biometric piece of data is being moved from one place to the other in the cloud. One needs to assure that during that particular transport, it doesn't get opened up so it can be exploited and taken away from the intended movement from a starting point to a destination. And finally is the common sense of system security, much like in our residences, whether they are private at home or whether they are corporate at our workplaces, none of us leaves the door unlocked. So that same sort of analogy applies into this domain, where system security means that we take the entire system that handles the biometric at time of capture, time of processing, time of storage, time of use cases, and all of these elements are secured at once to ensure that the system is in place. So that has to do with the pieces of technologies that get deployed in order to ensure that the identity data, the biometric data rather, is secured. From a process perspective, which is equally important and equally crucial, so I'm not speaking about one or the other. I'm saying that these two pieces need to work together in concert, and it's one and the other that work together. Obviously, is the idea of access control, controlling the access to the biometric data that only the ones who are authorized to use it for whatever purposes that it was intended to be used are the only ones that can access it. Another way of process control would be the idea of careful monitoring of that particular data, and also ensuring that that particular monitoring is constantly done by authorized personnel that has the ability to do it for purposes of security, to ensure that something doesn't stay dormant or something doesn't happen unknown or something that doesn't happen that is suspicious or problematic, and it doesn't have people who are watching over it carefully to ensure that it gets done correctly. And finally, I think one of the earlier points we touched upon, which is the application of this idea of multi-factor authentication, is to secure biometrics access with a multi-factor requirement. So it would not sufficient for somebody to go and update, say, their portrait or to update a new capture of fingerprints and whatnot, and merely take the original security that was created and collapse it to a mere password. The barrier has to be much higher in order to edit or change or update or do something to that biometric, and that would be the area of process.